What's going on, guys? Michael here, 360 Digital Closing Bell here on this beautiful March 25th, 2020. I'm live from an undisclosed location here in Denver, Colorado. A couple things before we dive into the digital ticker. My one big thing, I just want to mention, if you're not subscribed to Digital Closing Bell, please, please, please subscribe at www.oilandgas360.com. It's the best way to see this video and all other content. You can also see our Energy 360 Network on that website, which there are a boatload of great interviews. We just dropped one with the Port of Corpus Christi CEO, Sean Strawbridge, today. We also dropped one with Bernadette Johnson, the VP of Strategy Analytics at Enverness, yesterday. And we have a bunch more coming up. I'm excited to get them to. Also, if you guys are interested, I have a webinar that I would love you guys to check out. It's the Corporate Data Learning Series. These guys are hosting another event on advanced Excel and Power BI training. I love the corporate analytics. What these guys do is they actually, instead of just hosting webinars and showing you all this high level stuff and not actually teaching you anything, these guys take actual programming skills that are being deployed in large corporations right now, and they actually teach people those exact skills so they can go get jobs. It's the Corporate Data Learning Series. They're holding a 2-night boot camp on April 8th and 9th, 6 to 7:30. And what they're doing is they're walking people through advanced Excel on the first night, and then they're going to link to that database then in night two and build Power BI dashboards and analytics spreadsheets. It's really going to be awesome. You can register for that event at www.corporatedatalearningseries.com, and also get more information. You can check out more of it on my LinkedIn. Please check it out at Michael Tanner. With that, let's go ahead and dive into the digital ticker. SP 500 today, 2475. That's a 1.15% increase. NASDAQ, 7,384.3. That's down 0.45% today. The difference is NASDAQ's a lot more heavy tech stocks. S&P 500, really the biggest one, is the Dow Jones, is the large cap corporations. Dow Jones only up 495 points today to 239% increase, 21,206. U.S. oil, 24.24. That's down 0.37%, but that 12-month strip up to 36.08, or a 5% clip on day, which is really good. Natural gas up to $1.66 even. That's a 0.45% increase. That 12-month strip on natural gas, though, doing a little bit better, 0.52% increase, up to a $2.57 and 8 change. E&P securities contract, XOP, $8.57. That's a 1.1% increase. And our OIH contract, $4.35. That's a 0.23% increase. On the downside today for our biggest losers, Whiting Petroleum, $1.17. They were down 7%. Centennial Resources Corporation, they're down 11% to 40 cents even. And Range Resources, our biggest mover downside on the day, down 17% to $2.52. On the upside, 17%, a lot of green numbers, $1.06. Permanville Royalty Trust, good number to see. Camber Energy Inc., 88 cents. They're up 19% and moving 25% on the day up to $2.93. The North European Royalty Trust. And let's dive into our one big thing. Really, the big thing that I want to talk about is these ducks that are going on right now. And someone I went to school with, Andrew Cooper, who writes for S&P Platts, wrote a really great article that I'll make sure to link in the YouTube video that really talks about some of the ducks that are happening. Right now, there's about 400 to 800 ducks when you take a look at some of the different numbers between the different regions. He's focusing specifically on the Bakken. And what he wants to know is, are there any of these ducks that are worth completing? And really what he identifies is there's about 33% of them that sits in what's called McKenzie County, which is probably the most profitable county to drill in. And when you talk about oil and gas in North Dakota, and really what he does is he sits there and he identifies that there's only about 25% that are profitable at about ducks to complete at about $30-$35 a bill, which isn't that great of a number. So it'll be very interesting to see what happens with these ducks. I don't expect to see many of them getting completed, but if you look at these numbers, there's some, you know, especially, you know, he mentioned in that article, CapEx is dropping by 30-55%. So at that $30 WTI environment, there's only about 15% of that duck inventory can be completed, especially profitably, considering it's in McKenzie County. So if you're looking out, watch for what these ducks are doing and if companies are completing them. And with that, I'm going to go ahead and let you guys get back to work. Thank you for checking out 360 Digital Closing Bell. We will see you guys tomorrow.